Hey everyone, SS here, and welcome to the finale of Pokemon Volt White. Yes, that is right, we are finally here at the Pokemon League, ready to take on the Elite Four. I want to point out one thing. Mainly, this is, as I said, this is a re-recording, and there's quite a few reasons it happened. I'll explain why those reasons are throughout the video. Well, through the beginning of the video at least. I want to point out one thing, just to get this started. If you can see this, my entire team is at 85. Yes, that is way high, and it is definitely way too high for this, because these battles are very easy since I, like I said, re-recording, I've seen them all. But that's good, that way the battles don't drag on, I could breeze through them fairly easy. Which is good, because I don't like getting stuck on battles, especially not when these videos are already going to be long. I intend to divide the finale into two parts. This silly four part, it is summer, because it's actually recorded later than it should have been, almost two weeks after the Victory Road video is recorded. I'm going to point out one thing. I did plan on having co-commentators in this, but due to bad planning and things like that, it didn't happen, so I guess it's just me all alone. Nah, not really. But, yeah. There'll be more co-commentaries in my videos eventually. Alright, let's start this battle against Marsh. Oh, crap. I don't remember swapping to Staraptor. Oh, shit. This could be bad. Alright, I guess one of the main reasons I am redoing this, re-recording it, is a lot of these attempts at recording I've made, for some reason, my mic continues to do its disruption noise. Sometimes it's still, it just cuts out completely. I'm talking 1 minute, looking at the Camtasia recording bar, it's picking up my audio, and then boom, just like that, it, I don't know what to say, it, just stops. Oh, really? Oh, that's a bad start. Oh boy. Let me revive Staraptor. That's a great way to start. That has never happened, but that's mainly because of my inability to remember to switch to switch to Staraptor in the first place. Oh great, he's gonna hit Arcanine now, isn't he? And take him out with a critical hit somehow. Oh, okay, not this time. Lucky me. Alright. But yeah, I don't know why it's doing that. Honestly, I don't get it. It's probably doing it right now, according to Camtasia Bar. And I gotta figure this out. There should be no reason it's happening. Go ahead and put me to sleep. See if I care. Come on, Arcanine. You can wake up, can't you? Oh, crap. If you don't wake up, he's gonna get hit. Oh, he's done. Ah, this is not going well. But yeah, I mean, if anybody has a Triton AX180s and can tell me what the hell, you know, why it's doing this in the first place, that'd be great. Because it's really starting to piss me off. I mean, seriously, it's pissing me off that I've had to cut so many recordings and scrap quite a few of this alone just because of that problem. So, yeah. That's why, if you're wondering why I do sound a little bit annoyed, that is why. Because it just happened. Okay, suck. Let's suck him. Well, I'm gonna suck it to ya. Bad pun. I think that's a pun. I don't care. Okay, maybe that's sturdy. That was a waste. Bulk up. Good for you, dude. Cause it ain't gonna help ya. And, you know, you're probably gonna hear a lot of button mashing in the background because I am going to mash buttons to get this over with. I guess another thing to talk about, what is your favorite Elite Four or League? Since, I mean, it seems appropriate now that, since that's what we're doing. Wow, I can't even, I gotta start learning to think before I talk. Oh, well, whatever. Mine, I don't really know. I like a lot of the leagues, to be honest. I haven't played a Hoenn game in a long time, like, or not a long time, but in a while, like I've mentioned previously. So, it's the one I'm most unfamiliar with. I mean, I like the Sinnoh Elite Four, because there's a character, there's Elite Four Aaron, so you know what, that's kind of being biased, but that's my reason. I'm gonna stick with it. Now this usually takes itself out by a, or makes it easy to take out, because it usually tries to do high jump kick, which obviously won't affect Staraptor in the air. Yep, there it goes again, missing and losing half of, almost half of its HP. Now, good thing I hit it, now all is good. Dun-dun-dun, Conkeldurr. And so yeah, and feel free to answer that if you'd like to in the comments below. Now we're gonna swap Staraptor out, Arcanine's down. I guess we won't. That's what I was gonna use, is Arcanine. I forgot he went down, so you know what, we're just gonna Brave Bird this, hope for the best. We're gonna wing it! Ah, get it. Bad pun. A bad pun pulls off! Hooray! Well, bad pun sorta pulls off, I guess. Okay, Lucario and Crocodile, bad idea, so Samurott. Throw is a bulky Pokemon, but shouldn't be able to do much to my Samurott Beastly. My Beastly Samurott, why did I say that backwards? I don't know. I don't know half the things I say. Well, that's a lie, I usually do know what I'm saying, but not when it comes to recording, I don't. Good luck, hopefully that don't take Samurott out. Okay, good job. And there goes that Toxic Orb again. I'm pretty sure it's for Facade, but I don't know. Because he never actually used it the way I was intended to, I don't think. Random fact, it is currently 72 degrees outside when I am recording this. I guess something else as it's starting to approach. November is, and as most gamers know, November is a big, big month for game releases. There are quite a few big titles coming out, and there's quite a few I'm excited for. A lot of people are excited for Modern Warfare 3, well maybe not a lot, a lot of people that I've seen, like comments and stuff. I'm not sure about the game, honestly. I mean, I looked it up on Wikipedia, and obviously I know Wikipedia isn't all that reliable, but it seems to have given me the information I wanted to know, and they seem to be making a lot of changes that I don't necessarily like to, the multiplayer. I mean, I love playing Call of Duty multiplayer. I've been playing it since, well, actually, I didn't really have an Xbox at the time COD 4 was big, but I have played COD 4. I got my Xbox around the time World at War was the current one, so I wasn't too late. But I do enjoy playing Call of Duty online, though there are some things that really do piss me off. Why am I switching? I have Crocodile out. And everybody, any normal player, because I'm just a casual player on the game, I mean, I don't try to prove myself by doing those quick scopes or trick shots, I just want to have fun. I used to be kind of competitive with some friends about highest kill-death ratio. You know, if I had like a 0.3 kill-death ratio and sucked absolute ass at the game, I probably wouldn't care, because it's all for fun. Which is another reason that, like, videos I show, most of my videos, I'm not trying to prove anything with the videos I show on this channel. You know, if you can beat it, that's good for you, because I don't really care. I just want to have fun. So, if you play, you see, if I upload videos of Call of Duty or Battlefield or whatever to this channel, don't waste time pointing out that I'm like, oh, you suck, you shouldn't be playing this game, because I don't care. I want to play for fun. Whatever score I get is whatever score I get. Then Modern Warfare 2, I believe I had a 1.27 KD, which wasn't bad, honestly. Because in COD 4 and World at War, I was still getting really used to it and had absolutely horrible KD ratios. If you don't know what that is, it's kill-to-death ratio. COD 4, I had an absolutely horrendous one, like 0.7, because I was, you know, horrible at the game. World at War, I had a pretty bad one at the start, but later on I began to fix it at a pretty good rate. I think I had high 0.9s, almost 1, when I stopped playing it. Modern Warfare 2 was a 1.27, which I had, it's about where it's been the entire time I played Modern Warfare 2. Because I did get quite a few games where I had nukes, which is a pretty big surprise. I got a total of 13 legitimate nukes. No nuke boosting, I hated that. So stupid. Black Ops, I'm trying to get it back, actually, because I want to play it again. I did enjoy Black Ops. I don't remember what my KD was. It was pretty high, because I think almost every game I played in Black Ops, I went positive score. So I'm pretty sure it was high. And problem is, I don't have any map packs for Black Ops at the moment. And wow, I got it really off track. I realized I was talking about the different games coming out this November and December. But yeah, I'm excited. A little bit excited. What is the word? I can't think of the word. God darn it. A little unsure, neutral towards Modern Warfare 3. I think I need to see a bit more before I determine if I'm going to pre-order it. Saints Row the Third, however, majorly anticipating that game. I mean, I've seen some trailers, it looks amazingly badass, I'm going to say that. I mean, it is definitely a game I'm looking to getting. Because it just looks fun. I played the first and second one. They were amazing and fun as hell. If I still had them, I would definitely have LP'd them. I would definitely have done that. Fortunately, I do not have them, so it ain't gonna happen. I could probably get Saints Row 2. It's like $20, so I really want it. Oh, well, that's not really worrying about it. So yeah, Saints Row the Third. Definitely excited for that. What else? Assassin's Creed Revelations, I'm not entirely sure on its release date. I'm a little bit behind on Assassin's Creed. I played through 2, never did Brotherhood, though. Don't know why, I really wanted to, and I just never did. For whatever reason. So I gotta play Brotherhood, then Revelations. Is there any other big games coming out? It's November, December? I don't think there is. I can't think of any. Oh no, yeah, there is. Skyward Sword, Legend of Zelda, can't believe I forgot about that. And then a lot of those, oh my god, there are a lot. There's, Super Mario 3DS, I believe it's called, I don't really know. And then, oh my god, Mario Kart 7, or whatever it's actually gonna be called. So those are, I can't believe I forgot about those. I am a bad gamer. Bad me. Not really. But yeah, so there's a lot of great games coming out, so I definitely know it's gonna be on Antidote. Damn, stupid. Burn Heal. There's gonna be a lot of LPs of those kind of games coming out in the next couple months. I do plan on doing an LP of one of those big games coming out this holiday. Don't gonna tell which one, but I just basically hinted towards it. So I hope you'll definitely enjoy the game that I'm hinting towards. Hint, hint. Because it'll be a fun. It'll probably be blind. I'll probably go get it on its release. I'm going to probably pre-order it, and go get it on its release day, come right home, start recording it without any prior knowledge of the game, except for what I get from trailers and other stuff like that. That'll be fun. I love blind LPs. Like this one was, well, I don't know if this one would be considered a full-fledged blind RPG. What the hell? Blind Let's Play, because I knew the storyline and where to go. I just didn't know what the trainers would have. So, at minimum, it was a half-blind LP. Alright, we are fighting Caitlyn, and I've been talking about nothing about this game, but since it's so easy that I'm breezing through this, I really have nothing to talk about related to this. She always does this, but her whole team is psychic, so just have something with a powerful dark-type move, and you'll win. I haven't mentioned, but if you're wondering why Garchomp is not in my team, he's not in my team because Crocodile is faster, believe it or not, has more powerful ground-type moves, and has the dark subtype to help with, Crunch. So, the main strategy I use for this one that is Moxie. Once a Crocodile Moxie build-up was super effective, you're not gonna win. There's just no way it's gonna happen. May get outsped somehow, but you aren't gonna beat him, because that's two Moxies right there. Okay, well, off that subject, go to something else to talk about. Over the past, well, I've been gaining subs quite fast, I've noticed. I mean, I hit 400 last weekend, and I'm at 437, I think, as of the time this is getting recorded, so I'm very thankful to all you guys. A lot of people have been asking where the... It's not a GFX pack, it's actually just an icon pack, because I couldn't use do a background on it. Couldn't think of a theme for one, so it's just a bunch of icons. It's not under my control whether it's uploaded, you might be saying, but it's your icon pack. Yeah, but I asked a friend to upload it for me. So whenever it gets uploaded, then that's when it happens. So I hope you like it when it does come out. I will put a link to it in my channel bulletin or Twitter or something like that. Come on, this is just sad. This is literally the definition of sweep. And I've been playing some of my other games that I haven't played in a while over the weekend and week. I've been playing my Pokemon Battle Revolution. Fun game. I don't have anybody to play it with, unfortunately. My brother hates the game for some reason. So, yeah, it's kind of sad. I've been playing that. I was playing a bit of Super Mario Sunshine. I still love that game. Oh, Protect. Really? You just gotta spam that and stall this battle longer, don't you? Oh, man. So, yeah. Definitely having fun with that. I've also been playing... I got it yesterday. I believe so. I got the Battlefield 3 open beta. It's very fun, to be honest. And I'm kinda pondering if I should upload videos about it. I haven't fully decided as of the moment. But if any of you have Xbox Live Gold, preferably, and would like to add me and play some matches on that, feel free to do so. Though, like I said, I didn't really say it. I said it in the bulletin on my channel. I don't have any disc-based games. I have Castle Crashers off of the Xbox Live Arcade. I have an Xbox original, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, one of my all-time favorite games. Probably would. I don't know about LPing it, though, because it's such a long game and there's a lot of mature stuff in it. It would definitely be probably not something I should upload to my channel. I mean, there's a lot of cussing. If anybody's played it, they know what I'm talking about. I don't think I took any damage during that, did I? No, I didn't. Not at all. Okay. But yeah, so if you have Xbox Live, feel free to PM me your gamer tag, and I'll add you, and we can play some Battlefield 3 open beta. I don't really know why I'm calling it that. It's the full name, but Battlefield 3, very fun. Definitely got used to playing on Xbox Live again, though, and since my headset that I use is like a Turtle Beach, I've been told it's not actually a Turtle Beach, but whatever. It's like one, so it's very helpful for playing those kind of games. So, advantages, mine. Now, Grimsley, this guy's really easy, because, I mean, these whole Elite Four matches are simple. Let's just, Thunderbolt it. Super effective, it really helps you. It really does. Except when they barely survive because of Focus Sash. How I hate it so much. If that gets a critical and takes Substrike out, I won't be happy. Okay, good, because knowing me and my luck, that will happen. Full Restore! You annoying bitch. Gotta delay this battle. Just gotta. Come on. Crocodile, yeah, Substrike is not gonna face that. That won't work out too well, will it? No effect on with any of the moves Substrike has, with Crocodile being super effective. I mean, that's just plain stupid if I kept him out. And I am not stupid. Most of the time. Sometimes I can say some really stupid things, or make some really stupid comments. But, oh really? You just gotta delay this. God damn it. Surf then. Earthquake again, spamming moves, how original, AI. Okay, now I swear if Samurott faints because of that, I'm not going to be happy. Goodbye. Good riddance. Honch Crow. Get Samurott back. Zipstriker. Wild Charge. So you can Substrike and take it out and survive? Not likely. Well, we're about to find out. Substrike just struck you down. Ah, get it? Bad pun again. He survived! Amazing! The striker is such a beast! Such a beast. I love... My team in this turned out really well. Originally, I wasn't sure how it would work out. But, I mean, I think it's so well built that I didn't really even need to be this high in level to, win these guys, because in my Platinum team that I since transferred over to White version, they were so well trained with Ivy and Eevees, even though I've never fully understood how those work. I get the general idea. Why am I trying to do that? I think they were so well trained with Ivies and Eevees that my team is, my Black and White, not Black and White, Platinum team was able to take out Pokemon at least 10 levels higher than them with ease. So I was like, wow, that is pretty surprising. And that whole team I've actually kept on White and leveled up, and my Garchomp I had with Platinum, it has legitimately reached level 100. Took almost a year because I got Platinum back in September of last year. In fact, I kind of remember getting it. Alright, well, that was all the Elite Four, and I talked very little about them because I had really no need to talk about them, so let's head here, and it's glowing. Activate. Drop down into the basement. I don't know why. I mean, this is a really intriguing design for Pokemon League. All those damn stairs. Like, I can only imagine that what your character says when he find would say when he finds is like, "Where's a goddamn escalator when you need one?" Jesus Christ. Alright, well, I think that'll cut it off for this part of the finale. I will see you next time when we finish the second half and proceed in the rest of the way into the Champion's Room, Altar, Domain, whatever you want to call it. This has been SS. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. Hope you enjoyed the video. Have a great day, and I will see you next time. SS signing out.